Hey everyone, welcome back to Carrots and Olives. My name is Brittany, and today we are going to be talking about the best feeling fountain pen that I've discovered recently. So I want to first thank you all for all your well wishes from the last video. I did get sick, and you may be able to still hear it in my voice, but I am slowly healing and recovering. And so hopefully the way that my voice sounds doesn't bother you too much. So I ordered from Goldspot and my order arrived in record time, like many of the fountain pen retailers in the United States are able to do. And I decided to go with a Scribo. I've heard some great things after watching a couple of videos from Apple Boom and the DC Pen Show, and many people talk about Scribo. Now, this is a brand I have never heard of until probably last year, and that's just from watching YouTube videos and just doing some research online and on Instagram. So I decided to pull the plug and dive in. I ordered from Goldspot because they have the best selections of from US retailers, and the experience was really nice. I decided to also get a bottle of ink. I felt like maybe I should have got more than one bottle of ink, but these bottles are huge and quite pricey. Now, the ink I did select was the color Verde Mediterraneo, and it's this beautiful turquoise with wonderful shading. The price is quite high, but I find that the box is very sturdy and it has this really nice feature of a leather pull tab, and the bottle is huge, humongous. It's 90 mls, and that for me will last me a lifetime. Now on to the showstopper, which is the fountain pen itself. It comes in this really nicely well made pen wrap, pen roll, and it has some leather accents, and it comes nestled in one of the pen loops or the pen holders. So it is a nice, I want to say it's almost like a canvas material. It has a feel to it that makes it reminiscent of canvas to me, but it's made for two pens. And anyway, I ended up getting the Scribo Altrove, and this is the Puma. So it is not a piston fill, it is a converter fill, and it is an 18 karat gold extra fine nib. This one also has an ebonite feed. This is my very first fountain pen with an ebonite feed, and I'm really excited about it because I know that from learning from ebonite feeds, or learning about people who use ebonite feeds, it's mainly to help with ink flow or to better the ink flow to the nib. So I'm really excited about that. And we're just looking at the body. This color is really mesmerizing. I don't have many fountain pens that are purple or like pinky purples, and so this is my first. I'm really excited I decided to go with this color. With the crackled acrylic look. Now, this pen also has facets, and as you can tell, it has two facets, one on the front and one on the back of the pen, which allows it to stay put on the paper or a hard surface, which is great. And it's so comfortable in my hand. And so I would say that this is by far one of the most comfortable fountain pens I have in my collection now. And I've been kind of scouring the internet for other colors and trying to see what my next Scribo fountain pen is going to be. Now, one of the things about the nib is that it is a nib that requires a angle that's closer to the paper. Now, and I do have to remember that this pen is also an extra fine, so it's not like a huge gusher. However, when I write at the correct angle for this pen, it writes so well. But this pen has also made me realize how often I'm changing the angle that I'm writing, and this pen does not do well with different angles. So I am actually a high angled writer, or it seems like that's what I lean towards, and I'm finding that with this pen I have to write a little bit lower, which is a little uncomfortable for me, but it works. And when it works in a way to where it's nice when I can write at the angle. It's just I can't keep that angle for a long period of time. So here I decided to just do a little quote so you can see a close-up of how low of an angle I have to write. And I realized that it can be uncomfortable for me personally for long periods of writing, but the pen is so comfortable in the hand. It doesn't weigh too much, yet it does feel substantial. The nib is soft, but not overly soft to where I can't control like the width of the ink coming out for my writing. And these pens also come in a flex nib, and I was unsure whether or not I should get the flex nib or the non-flex nib, and I am happy with getting the non-flex nib. I realized that as exciting as a flex nib is, I don't like trying to use or having to use a flex nib for everyday writing. And what I want to be able to do is use my fountain pens for everyday writing. So maybe it could be something I get in the future, but right now the 18 karat gold nibs are just perfect. I just have to find maybe a thicker or a wider nib size that can accommodate a different angle to my writing. But anyway, this is just kind of like a first impressions. I've been playing around with it for a while now, and I will definitely be coming back to you with more thoughts on this pen at a later time. If you guys own this pen, tell me your thoughts, what you like and don't like about it, and I will catch you in the next video. Bye!